Today we are starting with a new topic, that is drug-receptor interaction. So this drug-receptor interaction contains two words, one is drug and second one is receptor. So basically drug is a small molecule, or either it can be antibody or biological product, which gives you the pharmacological activity. And receptor makes a macromolecule. There are certain various types of receptors are available. You can say that, say for an example, IHNs, kinase receptor, enzyme receptors. So these are the various type of a receptor. When drug binds to the receptor, it exerts the biological activity. So for any kind of a drug, for having a biological activity, receptor binding methodology is a very important thing. So today we are looking for what are the different kinds of a drug receptor interaction. So before starting this different kinds of a drug receptor interaction, let us first of all look how drug bind with the receptor. So drug bind with the receptor on two ways. Either it is a reversible bind or it can be irreversible bind. So two types of bindings are available, reversible as well as irreversible binding. Now most of the drugs contains the reversible binding, except some kind of drugs which possess the irreversible binding. Now this reversible binding is occurred due to the H bonding, say for example, it can be due to the contrast bonding. So this type of bonds are responsible for the reversible binding. Here, covalent bonding is responsible for the irreversible binding. For an irreversible binding, we can take one example of acetylene bonding. Say for example, bonding and phosphorus will bind to the acetylene covalent receptor via the irreversible binding, and it is the strongest bind. So basically, binding can be a reversible and irreversible. Now, how this binding occurs? What are the different types of bonds which is involved in a drug receptor interaction? So very first, we are starting with the first one is the covalent bond. Drug can be bind with the receptor with the first one is the covalent bond. Now remember, this is the strongest one. The energy involved is up to -22.10 kilocalorie per mole. And you can take the example of acetylene covalent and organophosphorus binding, which follows this kind of a binding event. So very first one type is a covalent bond type of a drug receptor interaction. Second, we can take that ionic bonding. So very second one type is ionic bonding. Now this, how ions are generated? So in our biological system, certain amount of acids like histidine, which are available, which is a kind of physiological pH, they are converted into ions. Say for example, if they are converted into positive ion, so from the drug, they will attract the negative ion. So this is how the ionic bond will form. So very second one type of a bonding for a drug receptor is ionic bonding. Here, approximately energy level available is -5 to -10 kilocalorie per mole. And this is happens, this kind of a bonding happens due to the opposite charge attraction of ions. So second one is ionic bonding. The third one we are looking for the ion dipole and dipole dipole bonding. Very third one kind of interaction between a drug and receptor is ion dipole and dipole-dipole bonding. Now how this dipole moment is generated? So in a organic molecules, due to the some kind of a positive and negative charge attached molecules, they will generate the dipole. Say for an example, plus charge and negative net charge. So between these two things, dipole will generate. But here, this kind of a bond formation have a lesser energy as compared to the ionic bonding. The energy level will be between -1 to -2 kilocalorie per mole. So third one type of bonding is ion dipole and dipole dipole. interaction. Now moving towards the fourth one of drug-receptor interaction is H-bonding. What we said that hydrogen bonding. Now how this hydrogen bonding can occur? So drug is the molecule like RS, or you can say that RH. So R can be NH2, it can be OH, it can be anything. So they produce a hydrogen ion. So this hydrogen will bind with the receptor. Say we can draw a very simple example. Say for an RH plus X. So X is the receptor, R is the drug. So why bind it? It will form the complex of RHX. So with the hydrogen bonding, receptor will bind with the drug. Here the energy level involved is around -3 to -10 kilocalorie per mole. So hydrogen bond can easily break, and it is irreversible type of binding can occur with the hydrogen bonding. So this is the fourth one type. The fifth one type we can take, that is a hydrophobic bond. Now how hydrophobic bonds are generated? So generally the bond itself is hydrophobic, it's water heading. Now consider one example, drug is there and receptor is there, which is surrounded by the water environment, because our body contains 60% of water environment. So we all know there is a general rule of that hydrophobic molecules are water heading. So now what happens? Drug having a hydrophobic end, receptor having a hydrophobic end. So they are trying to oppose the hydrophilic environment or waterless environment. In this way, they are coming towards near to them. So due to the going outside towards the hydrogen environment or hydrophilic or waterless environment, they will show the attraction between towards. Say for example, consider this is a water layer, this is a receptor, and this is a drug. Now, this drug having a hydrophobic molecule, and this receptor also having a hydrophobic molecule. So, due to the balance between this biological system, they contain some kind of a attraction or some kind of a interaction, which is known as hydrophobic bond interaction. So, very fifth one type of a hydrophobic bond interaction. Sixth one type of the drug receptor interaction is charge transfer. So what it says here is charge transfer. So charge will be transferred. Here the pattern will be followed is proton donor and proton acceptor. Proton donor, proton acceptor, or you can say that electron donor or electron acceptor. Here this case electron means donor, electron donor, electron acceptor. Now what is electron donor? So basically electron donor is electron rich molecule which gives the electron towards the electron acceptor, electron deficient molecule. Now say for example, if you have a furan, so furan is electron rich reagent which gives a electron towards, say for example, phenolic. Or in the biological system, phenylene is also present. So it will give the electrons towards the beryllium. So second type of sixth one type of interaction can be happen is charge transfer interaction. Seventh one type is water loss bonding. So water loss bonding can be happens in a hydrophobic molecule. So water loss forcing, you can also there is a sky interaction. When drug and receptor are non-bonding formation, there will be, you can say that a non-bonding structure is occurred, which is known as van der Waals bonding. So in a nutshell, when drug will bind with the receptor, it can have a seven types of interaction. First one is a covalent bonding, second one is aromatic bonding, third one is ion dipole interaction, fourth one is hydrogen bonding, fifth one is hydrophobic bonding, sixth one is charge transport, and seventh one is water transport. So these are the types of interaction that can occur with the wet drug binds towards the receptor. Apart from this, the important thing is the stereochemistry. We all aware about the lock and key model. So when, how the lock will be opened if key is a very specific. Now the key part here plays as a stereochemical aspect. So we can consider one example of diethyl sequester. So diethyl sequester contains a two form, cis and trans. But trans one is only active, while cis remains inactive. That is the due to the same aspects, or you can say that stereochemical aspects. So while you are learning drug receptor interaction, you should also aware about the stereochemical aspects.